Welcome to episode 56 of Sketch with Jeff. As always, I'm really excited to see you. I'm also thankful for you. You see, this week in the United States, we're thinking about things for which we are thankful. It's been a very challenging year for all of us, all around the world, and I'm grateful to be able to share these videos with you and connect with you. When I look back at all the episodes of Sketch with Jeff, I'm really thankful for all the animated friends who have joined me and helped me make drawings. There have been so many fun characters who have helped me explore art in the Guggenheim Museum. Everything from a pizza-eating lion to a drawing horse, from an accordion-playing dog to, well, monsters. There have been some fun characters who rip things and shake things, but my favorite character of all is, of course, Pencil.
I would ask all my friends to come to a big party.
I'm even thankful for noisy cartoon animals. I think one of the best ways to show somebody that you appreciate them, that you are thankful for them, is to make them a work of art. I have an idea for a work of art that you could make for somebody. You could share it with them and show them how you feel. Let's go to my drawing board and I'll show you what I mean. Come on. So for this project, I'm going to use thick paper. This is nice, thick watercolor paper. I'm going to fold it in half like a card and really press down on it. And now I'm just going to mark out four separate little spaces along the edge. I want them to be about the same thickness, about an inch wide, and then I'm going to use my scissors to cut into the paper. And if you need help with a grown-up to use scissors, then ask somebody, because they can certainly help you. What I'm doing is cutting each space and cutting each space a little longer than the one before it. So the one all the way on the left, it's only about an inch tall, and I'm just cutting those two lines. Then the next one in is about 2 inches tall, and the next one 3 inches and 4 inches. So when I open up the card, I can pop out that little shape. I want it to pop out, and you can see it actually becomes like a diamond shape. So then I have to do a little bit of careful folding to really make them pop out. I have to kind of fold the edges in just the right spot. And before I know it, well, I have these beautiful pop-out shapes from where I cut on the edge of the paper. I pulled the paper through, and then by carefully folding them, they pop out. I love looking at them like this. When I look at them with the bigger one on the top and the smaller one on the bottom, it reminds me of the shape of the Guggenheim Museum, the way that it gets a little wider at the top, smaller at the bottom. And then when I look down this way, I'm reminded of something else in the Guggenheim, the triangle staircase. It looks like almost a very similar perspective as I'm looking down into my pop-up card. And now on the thick paper, I'm actually drawing pictures of things that I am grateful for, thankful for. I'm drawing a picture of Pencil, my favorite animated character. I drew New York City because I'm really thankful that New York has been so strong in the last few months. I'm drawing hands of people who have been helpers during this very difficult time. And I also drew a picture of my family. I'm actually cutting each of those drawings out. They're also on thick paper. And I'm adding a little color. I actually colored them in just to give it a little more brightness. And I also cut out a couple of frames because I thought they might be a really fun part of this pop-up card. What I need to do is glue my frames or my drawings just on the front part of the part that pops out, just the front edge. Because if I glue things or tape them onto the front edge, I'll be able to fold the card down and then things will pop up when I open it. But they all have to be glued onto that same front edge. On the front of the card, I'm just writing a little title. I am thankful for. And then when you open it up, you'll be able to see the things that I really appreciate. So there's pencil and the helping hands and my family and New York City. And I've arranged them by taping or gluing them right onto the front of my pop-out pieces. It really makes for a very interesting and beautiful card and a nice memory of, and a reminder of all the things that I am thankful for. I'm especially thankful for my friend, Pencil. I appreciate Pencil so much. Pencil, how about you? What are you thankful for? Oh, wait, I think I can guess just from the photos on your wall.
My family?
You have a beautiful family, Pencil. I'll see you soon. My challenge for you this week is for you to make a card for somebody that you appreciate. It could be a pop-up card or it could be a card with a drawing on it, whatever you want to make, but tell the person how you feel and give them that card. I have a feeling they will really appreciate something that you made. And if you want to share it with us, you can take a picture and share it with us at Guggenheim using the hashtag SketchWithJeff. I always love seeing your art. Check back every Saturday for more episodes of Sketch with Jeff. And if you're in New York City, the Guggenheim Museum is open. Just check out the website for more information. In the meantime, I wish I could make a pop-up card for each and every one of you. I love connecting with you through Sketch with Jeff, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
A turkey, a turkey, mashed potatoes and a pumpkin pie, a pumpkin pie, a pumpkin pie. Mashed potatoes and a pumpkin pie.